Is the sex industry in Thailand doomed? All the red light districts from Bangkok to Phuket and Pattaya have become silent, with bars, nightclubs and massage parlors closed and tourists not able to enter Thailand. In this video, we ask the question, is the sex industry in Thailand doomed? If this is your first time on the channel, or you have returned and like the content, then could I ask you to please like, share and subscribe? It really does help me and the channel. Oh yeah, and don't forget to press the bell icon so you never miss out on upcoming videos. The coronavirus pandemic and the subsequent lockdown has left an estimated 300,000 sex workers out of a job, forcing many to ply their trade away from the relative safety of established venues and onto the streets. The shutdown to contain the coronavirus has virtually killed Thailand's party scene and forced sex workers like Ploy out of the bars and onto the near empty streets. Many, like Ploy, are scared, but they desperately need customers to pay their rent. Many of Thailand's sex workers had jobs in the relative safety of bars, working for tips, or were willing to negotiate and go home with customers. When workplaces suddenly closed, most of the girls returned to their families at home to wait it out, while hoping the crisis will end soon. Others, like Ploy, are forced to work the streets. Many girls are paying a heavy price for the movement restrictions that were in place, with many saying they had not had a custom for many days, and with the bills they are stacking up. Many girls are struggling to earn enough to eat, let alone pay the rent. Sex workers have flocked back to homes across the country in anticipation of several weeks of virtual lockdown before Thailand's night economy comes back to life. But will it come back to life? There are fears the effects of the pandemic could last for months, if not years, taking billions of tourist dollars from the economy and leaving those working in the sex industry destitute. They include sex workers, an illegal but widely accepted part of Thailand's nightlife. But it's not just the sex workers who will suffer. It's all the jobs that are a spin-off from the industry, like cleaners, security, tuk-tuk drivers, motorbike taxis, etc., etc. It is said that a Thai government emergency scheme to give 5,000 baht, or $150, to millions of jobless over the next 3 months will not include sex workers, because they cannot prove they are gainfully employed. The Empower Foundation, an advocacy group for the sex workers of Thailand, says entertainment venues make around $6.4 billion a year, many of them selling sex in some form or another. According to a 2017 report from Empower Foundation, over 85% of sex workers are employed in entertainment venues such as karaoke and beer bars, where they work in relative safety. According to the organisation, the sex industry in Thailand contributes between 4 to 10% of Thailand's GDP, but the workers have no rights. Women are suffering the most in Thailand from the virus, it says. Because prostitution is illegal in Thailand, as in most of Asia, sex workers are excluded from the government's unemployment aid. Many are mothers and their family's main income earner, forced into sex work by a lack of opportunities or low salaries in their communities. Rights groups estimate that there are at least 300,000 sex workers in Thailand, including tens of thousands of migrants from neighbouring Myanmar, Laos, Cambodia and Vietnam. These migrants have even fewer options than the locals when it comes to getting hired elsewhere. Many have been living off charity and food handouts for the last few months. The group has written an open letter to the government urging it to find a way to provide assistance to all workers who have lost their incomes. The coronavirus pandemic has infected 13.5 million people worldwide and has claimed 500,000 lives. It's still gaining momentum in many parts of the world. It doesn't discriminate, it attacks all, the rich, the unhealthy, the old. The virus is changing the conditions of underprivileged people from bad to worse, causing many to join the ranks of the vulnerable worldwide. The neon lights have gone out in Thailand's usually bustling nightlife hotspots of Bangkok, Phuket and Pattaya. Bars, clubs and massage parlours were among the first to shut down by COVID-19 in March 2020, when Thailand closed its borders to foreigners to keep the virus at bay. Before the pandemic, Bangkok was one of the most visited cities in the world. Over the years, The massive influx of foreign tourists has put Thailand's nightlife on the map. It also fueled a barely disguised sex industry, unrecognised but tolerated by the local authorities. The Thai government says the decline of red light districts had begun in previous years as sex tourism becomes a smaller part of Thailand's overall tourism industry. In 2018, more than 53% of visitors to Thailand were women. As a growing number of Chinese tourists flock to beach resorts in Southeast Asia, the stereotype of Thailand's tourism sector catering mostly to Western men is also changing. Has COVID-19 accelerated this shift? There are bars all over Bangkok that have been open for 10 to 15 years and now they are closed, and they are not coming back, a club manager in Bangkok's red light district, Pat Pong, has stated. But is Thailand's sex industry really doomed? Alongapo City and Angeles City had a prominent sex industry when the US military were stationed in Subic Bay Naval Base and Clark Air Base, respectively. When Mount Pinatubo, a volcano, erupted in 1991, it destroyed most of Clark Air Base, and the United States closed it down in 1992. Pretty much, the sex industry closed with it. Today, the sex industry is thriving again in Angeles City. It just goes to prove that even though major events can have a devastating result, the ability of humans to adapt and survive is strong. A point in case is the devastating earthquake and tsunami that tore through the tourism sector in Thailand. The industry adapted and survived. It will be the same with this COVID-19 pandemic. Unfortunately, there will be pain and suffering for many, but I believe the sex industry will survive, but it may look a little different in the future. For the thousands of workers involved in the sex industry in Thailand, they must find a way to survive this virus, and they will. We can only hope and pray. As Ploy says, we are more afraid of having nothing to eat than the virus.